Today's topic is weathering due to heat. We'll see how heat is making a large impact on the process of weathering, and we will see the different types of weathering which are occurred because of heat. So, weathering of rocks by heat. Weathering is a physical and chemical process. You all know there are some physical processes as well as chemical processes which undergo the process of weathering. Now, as rock expands and contracts, the heat creates a physical weathering process where the rock splits apart into fragments. In the figure, you can see the rock has been weathered due to the extreme heat. So, whenever there is the daytime, the rock gets heated and it gets cooled down during night. So, because of that, there is expansion and contraction of the minerals which are present in the rock. And because of this, the rock is getting fragmented or disintegrated into small particles, and the outer layer of the rock gets weathered out. It also contributes to some chemical weathering where moisture or oxygen in the atmosphere alters the chemical composition. So even heat is accelerating the chemical weathering also. Rock easily reacts to the temperature during the day and it starts expanding. And it reacts to the temperature during the night and it starts contracting. So this is how the thermal effects are seen in the minerals present inside the rock. In the figure, you can see that because of heat, see the changes in the structure of the rock and the texture of the rock, and how the layer by layer weathering of the rock takes place. We will further discuss about the types of heat weathering. The first example or first type is granular disk integration. In this process, because of large temperature in the hot desert, there is always extremely cold and extremely hot. So when this type of temperature is seen, the rock, it starts weathering, and because of the expansion of the minerals every time and contraction, there is a lot of stress which is created on the rock, and the small molecules or fragments gets out. It leaves the surface of the rock and it is getting gathered in near the surface of the rock in the form of small granules, and that is called as granular disintegration. Now here we know that heating means there is a role of high temperature. The temperature plays a significant role in the process of mechanical through heating and cooling. So during the day, the rocks are getting heated and they start expanding, whereas during the night, the rocks is remaining cool and it doesn't expand. It works opposite. It contracts at the night when the temperature is cooled. So this cycle of contraction and expansion makes the rock to flake off. Flake off means what? So that the outer layer of the rock is separated from the inner layer of the rock. Next is the shattering type. In the case of shattering, because of large amount of heat, the rock particles, it starts breaking off. So the process of shattering, it makes the sound. It makes the sound very similar in the way when we fire a pistol, we get a sound. The same sound is created when the shattering process is undergoing. In this type of process, the rock is broken down with large amount of sound is created during this particular process. Now, next type is block disintegration. So in this block disintegration, basically it works on the sedimentary rock. Now, sedimentary rock is being created because of different segments. So there is some joint and there is some gap between each and every segment. So when these types of rock which are combined together of different material, when they start contracting and expanding, so there is lot of stress which is created at the joints of the rock. So when there is a weathering of this type of rock, then definitely the weathering takes place block by block. So because of this, it is called as block disintegration. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel.